students, up till now, you should have understood and also you should have solved some problems related to moments. Today, we are going to verify this law of moment, that is, principle of moment, using the Bell-Lyon lever. Okay? This is experiment number. Experiment number 3 in your manual. Okay? See what it says? Aim is to verify the principle of moment using the Bell-Lyon lever. Okay? What is the principle of moment? It says that the algebraic sum of the moment of a system of coplanar force about any point in the plane is equal to the moment of resultant about the same point. Okay? So whatever the number of forces are there, if you take the moment of n number of forces about any point, okay, so that should be equal to the moment of resultant about the same point. So, do you correlate that this particular principle of moment is something related, or it is Wellington law of forces? Okay, so we'll verify that Wellington theorem. So students, this is the apparatus to verify the principle of moment. Now this particular apparatus consists of, as I have told earlier, that it is having a bell crank. Okay? Bell crank is nothing but an L-shaped figure. That is nothing but, here it is a wooden L-shaped member. Okay? This member is having a shorter arm at one side, that is a vertical shorter arm, as well as it is having a longer horizontal arm. Okay? If you see on horizontal arm, there is serrations given. Okay? So these serrations are basically at some fixed distance from a pivot O. Okay? So this point is pivot, and the serrations are given at equal distance. The distance between the two serrations is 5 cm. Okay? And you will see that there are 3 number of hangers which are given. You can load the hanger, or you can place the hanger anywhere at your convenient, okay, and you need to take 4 number of observation. Okay, so here there are hanger, you can place at any point and take the reading. There are weights available here. We can load the hanger at any convenient weight as per your observation you require, and then you can take the reading. Okay, coming at the shorter arm, there is a hook given. And to this hook, there is a chain provided, and to this chain, there is a spring balance. Okay, so if you see in initial condition, when we start our experiment, a shorter arm consists of a pointer. Okay, shorter arm consists of a pointer, whereas there is another pointer from the top which is mounted to the base. Okay, now here, as the system is not vertical, okay, this shorter arm is not vertical, so initially what we have to do is that we have to adjust the setup in such a way that this particular upper vertical arm should coincide with the upper pointer. Okay, so there is a screw given for adjustment. Okay, we need to turn the screw. In such a way that the pointer on the shorter arm will exactly coincide with the top pointer. Okay, fine. Now here the pointer coincides. Now because of this particular initial setting, there is some amount of tension which has been observed on the spring balance. Okay, why it is observed? Because what happens is that the hangers are provided on the longer arm because it exerts some weight. Okay, though we are neglecting the weight of this hanger, but still there is some amount of weight which has been exerted by the hanger, and also the horizontal arm is having some amount of weight. Okay, so because of this particular weight, this particular bell crank gets rocked initially. Okay, so that is what was the adjustment with the help of the screw, which we now made as 0. But there is some reading which has been observed on the spring balance, that is called as initial tension. Okay, so that particular reading we will have to take, that is called
TI, that is initial tension of the on the spring balance.
There are hinges provided on the longer arm, that is nothing but horizontal arm. We have to provide weights on the hanger such that we give proper amount of load on the longer arm. We can have any amount of load can be given at any distance we want. Okay. So say suppose if this is the configuration where we have added 1 kg load at the first hanger, that is W1 is 1 kg, second hanger W2 is 1 kg, and at the third hanger the weight is given as a half kg. Now due to this loading condition, what happens is that this particular bell crank rocks in the presence of this vertical loads. Now if you see here, the pointer has been shifted by whatever amount of whatever the combination of load you apply with the distance you give. Okay? And there will be some amount of tension which you can observe on the spring balance, that is nothing but the final tension. You need to take 4 number of readings, observation, with different loading conditions and at different distances. Okay, you can take this second and third, whatever combination you want. The distance between the first load and the pivot is x1, whereas the distance between the second load and the pivot is x2, whereas the distance between the third load and the pivot is x3. Okay, so x1, x2 and x3 are the 3 different position of weights, and there is a spring balance which gives you the tension and whose distance from the pivot point is 0.21 meter, that is 21 centimeter. Okay, so we are having all the data related to calculation like W1, W2, W3. We convert this into Newton. We have X1, X2, X3 that we can convert into meters, and we have the tension which is readily observed on the spring balance, that is in kg, and we have the distance of 0.0 to the hanger, that is nothing but 0.21 meter.
So students, after taking at least 4 number of observation and then writing it in observation table, we will come to the calculation part where we are trying to draw this free body diagram, FBD, of bell crank lever. Okay, we had seen W1, W2, W3 are the 3 weights which we added on the longer arm, which was pivoted at this point O. And the distance from this O, that is a fixed point or a pivot point, W1 is having an X1 distance, W2 having the X2 distance, and W3 having X3 distance. So W1, W2, W3, whereas X1, X2, X3 are known to us because we decide the weight, also we decide the loading distance. Coming to the shorter arm, I have already told you that there is a spring balance which exerts the tension, which gives us the tension, and which is at the distance of y, that is nothing but equal to 0.21 meter. Okay, so it is 21 centimeter. Okay, with this all information known to us, we come to the conclusion calculation part. Where we try to find out what is the moment. Okay, now we will see here, we will verify the principle of moment, where it states that the moment of each and every force, like W1 into X1 distance, W2 into X2 distance, W3 into X3 distance, should be equal to T into Y distance. Okay, if it becomes 0, that is T into Y is equal to the moment of all the forces, then we verify the moment. Okay, so now writing the equation for the moment, summation of moment about point O, if you consider, let us write down T into Y minus W1 into X1 minus W2 into X2 minus W3 into X3. Okay, so this is the moment where we have taken from point O, T into Y, anticlockwise moment, so positive, whereas W1 into X1 negative, W2 into X2 negative moment, W3 into X3 negative moment. Okay. Now here, if the summation of moment about the point comes to zero, that is summation of moment about the point O has to be equal to zero. That is, we say principle of moment is verified. But normally, if you see, when you calculate the observation, you will find that summation of moment does not come exactly equal to zero, but it comes close to the zero. Okay, there are various problems. That is why the summation of moment doesn't come equal to zero. Like we are not considering the weight of the hangers. That is one problem or one parameter. Second, by taking the reading of T, that is the spring balance, the stiffness of the spring may not be right. There could be rust in the spring, so it does not give the exact reading. When the scale on the spring balance is not proper, there is a parallax error while taking the reading. So these are the some of the errors which are there. So the moment doesn't come equal to zero, but it approaches towards zero. Okay. So still, if the moment does not come zero, still we can say that the principle of moment is verified, because the moment of about a given point comes closer to the zero. Hence, we can conclude the principle of moment is verified with the help of Bell-Craig given. Thank you.